How's it going, everybody? This is Cameron White with White Light Astrology, and welcome back to your favorite weekly horoscope, What the Fuck is Going On in the Universe, for July 1st through July 8th of 2019. Thank you guys so much for being here and liking and sharing and commenting and subscribing. I love and appreciate every single one of you guys. And we're finally here. We finally made it to July. If you've watched my monthly horoscopes already, you know that we're getting into quite an intense month with a lot of things going on. And one of the one thing I want to hit on about this week is this week kind of starts it all, because this week's highlights, we have Mars ingressing into Leo, we have Venus ingressing into Cancer, we also have Saturn on the South Node, we have the solar eclipse this week, and by the time we get into next Monday, we're going to be having Mercury station retrograde. So that's a handful of transits to happen in just one little tiny week, especially with Saturn on the South Node and the eclipse season starting. So this week I really think is going to play out into a bigger picture as the coming weeks follow. However, let's go ahead and jump into the horoscope. So on Monday, July 1st, we're going to be having the Moon conjoining Venus at the last degrees of Gemini, right before the Moon enters Cancer later on this evening on Monday. And while the Moon is in Gemini, like we talked about last week, this is really just trying to understand everything, get a good picture about everything. It was opposing Jupiter, kind of going, what do I do with all this information? What does it mean for me? What is this going to develop into? As the Moon's in Gemini, still working on its thoughts and its ideas, the Moon's going to conjoin Venus, where Venus is, you know, still valuing learning more information, bringing new things in, stimulation, exciting moments. Like, in the moment is a good way to put Venus in Gemini. And so while the moon conjoins Venus, I think this is just a big time of looking at, like, hey, there are other ways to look at this. There are more factors that need to be at play. We haven't taken in all the information yet. However, as the Moon conjoins Venus, this is kind of going like, you know, we want more information. This is definitely good. We want to keep stimulating this vibe. We still want to keep, it's like, you know, even though right now with the eclipses and everything, how, like, weird everything is, this Moon conjoining Venus is kind of like getting the right idea of how you want things to go, of what things you're trying to connect to. But also on July 1st, we're having Mars ingress into Leo. And I talked a lot about that in my monthly horoscopes. However, as Mars, again, he's like this angry planet. It's the malefic. It's, you know, hot. It's fiery. It's dry. It wants to sever and cut and sting. Mars is progressive and helpful and constructive in the areas of life that we need to take action on, be decisive, engage and initiate things. And Mars can be very constructive. However, while Mars is in Leo, I think the one thing that's really going to be important is knowing the difference between acting out of our ego and acting out of our pride and wanting to make sure that we have the loudest roar almost, in a sense, or when we're actually taking action on things that actually acquire our emotions. Like, I can't remember if I was watching like National Geographic or something like that, but they talk about how the male lions don't really do anything, and it's usually the female lions that kind of attack and kill and everything. And I want to kind of use that as an analogy for Mars and Leo. Like, you don't always have to engage and enact on everything that calls, you know, your attention. Mars in Leo is about focusing on what matters right now, what's going to, again, I've been hitting on this a lot, what does it look like taking action with integrity and still being in authenticity? But I think while Mars is in Leo, we're going to act that out and we're going to see what that looks like. What does it actually look like to act authentically, to act out of our, you know, not necessarily just out of our pride, but out of loyalty, out of strength? This is a fixed fire sign, and fixed signs keep things the way they're supposed to be, and fire signs like to burn things up. They like to go really fast. They like to, you know, make things warm and pleasurable almost, in a sense. And so while Mars is in Leo, the one thing I want to hit on is we start this week with a bang with that. This is definitely the time to really look at how you're taking action and what that is going to develop into. Now, as we go into Tuesday on July 2nd, that is when we're having the solar eclipse in Cancer. The Moon will leave Gemini and enter Cancer later on Monday evening. However, as the Moon goes into Cancer and we start the solar eclipse, like, this is a pretty big deal. The next 2 weeks are going to be emphasized on this eclipse stuff. And, you know, right before I recorded this, because I'm recording it super early, I just read about how the Robert Mueller's testifying in court on July 17th on the lunar eclipse. And it's like, mwah, like, yes, like, that's, astrology just does that type of stuff. And with the solar eclipse happening, beginning, you know, the whole eclipse cycle, the one thing I wanted to hit on is we're going to see stuff coming back up from January that are going to start to kind of reveal itself and, you know, come to a fruition and come to a close. But while this is a solar eclipse, this is like the sun's in Cancer wanting to embrace trust, empathy, all of those keynote words I've been saying about Cancer. And as the moon goes through it, and we're supposed to be resetting those intentions because it's supposed to be a new moon, that light gets cut out. The one thing I wanted to hit about this eclipse is, where is that, you know, if you're in a big room, or let's say you're at a concert, something really scary. Say you're at a concert or a nightclub, and all of a sudden, all the lights went out. I mean, it's already dark in there, but like the stage lights and everything else just went out. And then they come back on. Everyone kind of freaks out for a second, but things kind of continue to normal. But then everyone goes, what happened there? That's kind of like a solar eclipse or a lunar eclipse. However, why I bring that up is when this eclipse happens, notice what area in your life kind of just all of a sudden gets attention to detail. Or I should say, actually pulls your attention away to whatever it is. And I mean, this shouldn't be anything new. It should be pretty obvious by now. We've had the nodes in Cancer and Capricorn for quite some time, and we've had the eclipses beginning already. However, as the solar eclipse happens, like, just expect things to take your attention and take your focus away on whatever that matter is. But then on Wednesday, on July 3rd, that is when we have Venus ingressing into Cancer. And Venus is, you know, wanting to reconcile. She's wanting to unify things. She's wanting to bring things together. And while Venus is in Cancer for the next couple of weeks, this is really going to look like, you know, where am I actually valuing, I don't want to say valuing my emotions, but what part of my emotions, what part of my trust, where am I investing that value in? Where am I giving my energy away, almost in a sense? And it's kind of like taking stock of, hey, what do I have energy and value for versus what's kind of draining me? And as Venus goes into Cancer, I think this is just going to be a really big look at, like, for, especially for the next couple of weeks, how we can bring more value, unification, and togetherness to more of what our emotions are wanting. And I say emotions very broadly and generally. Yeah, that word gets thrown onto Cancer a lot, just like all of the other water signs. That's not to say that fire and earth aren't extremely emotional as well. However, why I like using water for emotions, and especially Cancer, is because emotions are most of the time kept on the inside, are protected, are shelled off, and are always churning, and they're always, it's, you know, Cancer is a double-bodied sign. So there's always two perspectives to look at things, and I think that has a lot to do with this. And so as Venus is in Cancer, this is kind of like really valuing what has been protected and what has been nurtured on the inside, and more of just kind of diving into that and embracing it, valuing it, seeing what it can create. Also on Tuesday, we have Saturn conjoining the South Node, and this is a pretty big deal. While the South, I think it's going to be exactly, 17 degrees in like 30-odd minutes or something like that, or 40 minutes. And while Saturn's on the South Node, I talked a lot about this with Joe Gleason. If you haven't watched the video about the eclipses that I did, you should definitely watch that. But we talk a lot about how this is kind of like putting everything into a box and lighting it on fire. The South Node, of course, is like what we're naturally good at and what we have, but isn't necessarily working anymore, and it's kind of holding us back, so why are we using this? It's kind of like having like a super old laptop. Like, this is actually a good analogy. I have a laptop from 2010, I think. It can like burn Blu-ray DVDs, and it's super big and it's super thick, and I don't know why I have it. I should probably get rid of it. But Saturn conjoining the South Node is kind of like, these things that are holding us back, that are taking us backwards, need to be released, need to be not necessarily cut off is a way to put it, or released, that's not a good way to put it. More as if it needs to be handled. It needs to be put there needs to be a restriction put on it. There needs to be a blockage put there, or a wall, something to divide the two. And I think that's going to be really important as we go into Wednesday, because we're just leaving the solar eclipse. Something's going to get brought to our attention. Venus goes into Cancer. We're a little bit more aware of what we're feeling and valuing that. But Saturn conjoining the South Node is kind of like, sometimes you just got to do what you got to do, and sometimes it doesn't always look good. But then as we go into Thursday, things starting to light up for the rest of the week. That's when on July 4th, we're going to be having the moon enter Leo, and it will be conjoining Mars and Mercury, and it'll square Uranus. So while the moon goes into Leo, I mean, like, it'll be July 4th, everyone's going to be partying and shooting off fireworks, however. By the way, if you have dogs, please put on music for them. Stop letting your dogs freak out and stop throwing them outside when there's fireworks going on. Shouldn't have to explain that by now. It's 2019. But one thing I wanted to hit on is while the moon's in Leo, where we're starting to feel grand and we're starting to feel a little bit more confident, it is going to conjoin Mars. It is going to conjoin Mercury. And I think this is kind of helping us put a decisive factor on what direction we're going in, what thoughts we're having, what mindset we're putting on everything. while Mercury and Mars are in Leo, wanting to, you know, do things very big and grand and loud and extravagant in a sense, the moon can very much enable that type of behavior. And that's okay. It's a good thing, especially if you're wanting to act out in big ways right now in your life. But it is going to be squaring Uranus, and Uranus, you know, extreme ups and downs, you don't really know, it's unpredictable. Just be aware of you getting too, you know, hot-headed is a good way to put it with the moon in Leo, a little bit too passionate and into the moment, and not let that passion overwhelm you to where you make a crucial mistake, you know. Sometimes we all get lost in the heat of passion. And then on Friday, on July 5th, that's when we're going to have the moon start to make a trine to Jupiter. And I think after the moon leaves that conjunction with Mars and Mercury and starts to get a little bit more of a level head, it's kind of like knowing where you're taking action, where you're directing your energy, and also having the logical understanding and reasoning behind that to back you up. But then while the moon starts to later on apply to a trine with Jupiter, this is kind of going like, hey, there's more to the story. If you keep feeling this good, if you keep living passionately and living from your heart and not being afraid to express that, there's room for growth here in a lot of different ways. And I think that's what that Jupiter trine is going to symbolize. But then as we get into this weekend, that's when the moon's going to be going into Virgo, and it's going to square Jupiter, and it's going to trine Saturn later on. And, you know, while the moon's in Virgo, you know, I talk about this like all the time, at least once a month, because the moon's in Virgo once a month. But, you know, it's kind of a good time to organize, like clean your house, clean your room, whatever it is, get yourself, you know, doing the things that are going to remediate that. But while the moon's in Virgo starting to square Jupiter and trine Saturn, I think this is about taking disciplinary action. Even though, you know, you can't have fun, you can't party, you can't do all the things that you want to do right now, making the small choices and taking the small steps that you can in this moment are going to be extremely crucial later on. And I think that's really going to help sustain us and give us some security and some stability as we move forward. And then as we get into Sunday, that's when the moon is actually going to be trining Saturn, and it will be in opposition to Neptune. And again, I can't hit enough on like doing things consecutively and consistently, being detailed, taking one step at a time, taking one day at a time. I think that's going to help kind of sustain us a little bit during this eclipse season, especially since it's trining Saturn. Saturn loves, you know, security and commitment and responsibility and all that shit. But as the moon opposes Neptune, I think this is about really going like, you know, it can be so easy to get lost in everything and in anything, especially with Neptune and Pisces being like, you know, it's stuff like the internet, it's stuff like our phones, it's stuff like media, like, you know, it's these vast worlds that influence so much of our, you know, society, but they're not, I don't want to say it's not real, because it's very real, but it's not exactly reality. And so as the moon opposes Neptune, this is kind of like a look at like, you know, this is how things can actually look realistically. And this is what realistic results look like. And not everything is confusing or, you know, an illusion or whatever. Like things can actually be simply put as long as you put in the work and the consistency and the reality, the sense of reality to things. But then we get into Monday as we get into next week, and we start it off. We got a lot going on. We got the moon entering Libra. It's going to start squaring Saturn and squaring Venus and the sun. Then we have Mercury stationing retrograde, and then Mercury is going to conjoin Mars as Mars is basically smacking Mercury in the face. And so as the moon goes into Libra, this is kind of like trying to hold it all together, trying to balance it all out. It's squaring Venus. It's squaring Saturn, where the moon doesn't know who to listen to right now. It's in a Venus-ruled sign. Venus is in the moon's ruled sign. There's this mutual reception there. But Saturn's in its domicile going like, no, still. The one thing I wanted to hit on is when we get into Monday and Mercury stations retrograde, it's going to feel like we're just trying to hold everything together. Like, don't rock the boat, you know, ha ha ha. And that's important to not rock the boat. But while Mercury stations retrograde and it's on top of Mars, it can be hard to, you know, keep that balance and that stability. So if one side falls over to the other side, let it fall. There's no need into keeping that from happening because it's probably going to happen anyway. But as we get after this weekend and we start next week on the Mercury retrograde, I think this is about remaining cool, calm, and collected, knowing when to say something because it matters at that time versus saying something that doesn't matter for something or about something that doesn't matter. This is about doing things that matter and kind of like not wasting your time on the things that don't. Like, where do you really value your trust? Where do you really value your connection with other people and that empathy? And while we have Mercury and Mars in Leo and the sun eventually going into Leo, this is like, you know, where do you value yourself and what light do you put you in and how do you enact that? And are you going to keep that in check? Are you going to keep that within integrity for yourself? Or are you going to get the, are you going to let your emotions get the best of you? So I really think that as we start next week, it's going to be really good to look at things through a clear way and take things one step at a time. But as we go into next week, not a lot's happening, and this is exciting because there is a lot going on this week, and it's really important to embrace all of this and take your time with it, because next week, we do have Mercury stationing retrograde on Monday of next week, so we'll be dealing with that for the most of next week. But other than that, we just have the Sun conjoining the North Node, and it will be opposing Saturn, and we have the lunar eclipse starting not next Monday, but the Monday after that, I think. Anyway, that is next week. Not a whole lot's going on, but this is the week where everything is going on. So take things one step at a time, one day at a time. We'll get through this. And then by just like that, we'll be at the end of July going into August. Everything will look better for the most part, but at least we can actually start having some fun. But with that being said, thank you guys so much for being here and liking and sharing and commenting and subscribing. I love and appreciate every single one of you, and I'll be seeing you next week.